Taylor, well, during your break from the rain today, you might go hunting in your yard for signs that the 17-year cicadas are making their way from underneath the ground into the surface. And joining us this morning to talk more about Brood X is our bug guy, University of Maryland entomologist Dr. Michael Raupp. Good morning. It's great to see you.
Hey, Jen, so nice to join you this morning. Look at this. These are the parents. I know this is a little Gary Larson-esque, but hey, these are the parents of those little teenagers. And guess what? They're almost ready to go. In fact, I went out last night and I said, hey, gang, how would you like to go and meet some folks? And they said, sure. So here is one of the very first periodical cicadas that we'll be seeing in just a few short weeks here in the DMV. So let's see if he can give you a little wave.
Oh, my gosh.
There's a little cicada wave. He's saying, hey, I can't wait to get out from underground. I've been there for 17 years. So, Jen, what folks can be looking for right now, we're seeing lots of signs of cicada activity. If you go out underneath your tree and you see holes like this in the ground, guess what? This is going to translate into about 1.3 million cicadas per acre. This is underneath my maple tree out back.
Wow. So if we see those holes, what does that mean? That they've already come up and they're starting to climb up the trees?
Nope, they're getting ready.
Okay.
What they'll do is about a month ahead of schedule, they'll begin to build that exit gallery, because when it's time, when that soil temperature hits about 64 degrees Fahrenheit, they know that's the cue to get up and out and go to the big party up in the treetops.
I mean, I just think this is such an amazing nature story and really a love story, if you want to look at it that way, because that's why the boys make all the noise.
The boys make the noise. It's going to be a big boy bid in the treetops. It's only the males that sing. And Jen, then it's all about romance. How much better can this possibly get? So they've been teenagers underground living a COVID-like existence, social distancing. When they come up out of the ground, they're going to want to get in those treetops. It's going to be a cicada palooza.
You're absolutely
right. This is unique.
Dr. Fauci better not see these cicadas. He's not going to be happy with their lack of social distancing, that's for sure. And listen.
Well, they do have masks.
They do. Describe how they make their noise, because it's only the boys that make the noise, and they have something special on them.
Yeah, the male cicada has what we call a tympal organ on either side of its abdomen. This is like a little drum head. And what they can do is vibrate that drum head. Their abdomen is actually hollow to act as a reverberation chamber to amplify that sound. And when they're up in the treetops and they're chorusing, that's going to hit somewhere between 80 and 100 decibels. The sound of a jet aircraft going on the way to BWI or a lawnmower in the backyard. It's going to be pretty spectacular.
And we are the epicenter of this whole phenomenon, and it's not going to last long, so you want people to enjoy it.
Absolutely. This is a chance for children of all ages to go outdoors on a bright, sunny day, see a phenomenon that happens nowhere else on Earth, nowhere else in the universe probably, and just enjoy all the various elements that Mother Nature has to offer. It's going to be like having a National Geographic special in your own backyard. So we hope people will go out and enjoy this thing. It only happens a few times in a lifetime.
All right, so tell people again when they might actually start to see the cicadas and when they're going to start to hear them.
Yeah, we're going to have the Vanguard coming out anytime. I think as we start to move into the early weeks of May, we'll definitely begin to hear reports. Then it's going to crescendo. So by the second and third weeks of May, and definitely by Memorial Day, hey, it's going to be peaking out. And then during the first week of June, it'll begin to tail off. And by the end of June, they'll all be gone. So they're going to be with us probably the very first ones. They could come out as early as the last week of April, and they're going to be here through June. So there'll be a nice 8-week period. You can go out and enjoy the periodical cicadas.
And you're going to be with us a lot, too. We're so lucky to have you in our own backyard, just like the cicadas, because you're wanted nationally to talk about these. So thank you so much for joining us.
It's always my pleasure, Jen. Hey, go out. It's going to be spectacular. And look for those holes in your yard. That's going to tell you you're going to have some pretty cool teenagers out there.
I can't wait. I'm going to look later today. Dr. Raupp, thanks for joining us as always, the Bug Guy.
Have a nice Sunday.
Thank you. You too. We could do